There's a church in the valley by the wildwood. No lovelier place in the dale. No spot is so dear to my childhood as the little brown church in the vale. Oh, come, 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 come to the church in the wildwood. Oh, come to the church in the vale. No spot is so dear to my childhood as the little brown church in the vale. How sweet on a clear Sabbath morning to list to the clear ringing bell. Its tone so sweetly are calling, oh, come to the church in the vale. Oh, come, 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 come to the church in the wild. Come, oh, come to the church in the vale. No spot is so dear to my childhood as the little brown church in the vale. From the church in the valley by the wildwood, when day fades away into night, I would fain from the spot of my childhood wing my way to the mansions of light. Oh, come, 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 come to the church in the wild. Childhood as a little brown church in the vale.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are, my Church in the Wildwood family. This is going to be a very unconventional virtual service for those who attend and maybe those who haven't attended. We don't want to leave people out in the cold all by themselves just because we can't gather in the church. I'd found a very good reading that one of the members of the congregation sent to me, and it's very true. I've said this before. With church doors shutting across America, it's time for us to show that the church has never been about the building. We are the church. So in that spirit, let's begin. Welcome to the Church in the Wildwood service, virtual. Welcome all message bearers and healers. Obviously, we will not be able to do messaging today because this is pre-recorded. However, I would like to end with a healing meditation for those that would like to stick around for that. And I do invite you to do that. My name is Reverend Jennifer Faye Smith, and I will be conducting the service today. We have already sung, or you've already heard, our Church in the Wildwood song that was played at the beginning. Hopefully that warm some hearts out there. I know that that song is very near and dear to me. It's going to be hard today, obviously, with singing, with the technology that we have going here, but I have picked out some new songs, so they'll be new to everybody. And in this way, there won't be the struggle to remember the lyrics. You won't have to. I'm going to try and have them posted in so you can read them if you'd like, but I chose some music that I thought was specific to today's needs in our world. I would like to start with an invocation followed by the Lord's Prayer. I do invite you to join me in the Lord's Prayer. Divine Creator, Blesser of all things, we thank you most humbly for that which we have, that we can still come together, if only virtually, and show that we are there for each other, that you remind us that we are not alone, that your love is ever present, in the kindnesses that are done by people every day, even during times of crisis. We ask you to bless all of our hearts. We ask you to bless those who are most at risk and most in need. And we ask you for your kindness in sharing the love that you have for us, through us, that we may bless others who maybe are more in need than we are. Bring us comfort and peace in this time of fear. Remind us that we are always loved and we are always cared for we are your children. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you. Today's reading is from J.R.R. Tolkien from The Lord of the Rings. You can find Divinity anywhere. I'm sorry, it's The Fellowship of the Rings. I wish it need not have happened in my time, said Frodo. So do I, said Gandalf. And so do all who live to see such times. But that is not for them to decide. All we have to decide is what to do with the time that is given to us. I thought that was very appropriate with everything going on in the world today. Before we go on to the next song, I would just like to read the principles of the Church in the Wildwood. Obviously, we don't have the books here for you to read those. But if you could just listen along. We believe in infinite spirit and that deity is infinite spirit. All phenomena of nature, both physical and spiritual, as the expression of infinite spirit. The immortality of the soul and a path of eternal progress open to every human soul. Communication between all spiritual entities and humans. Personal responsibility. Prophecy and healing as divine attributes proven through mediumship. The highest morality is contained in the golden rule, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. All right. At this point, I'm going to play the next song. It's one you've probably maybe not heard before. It's certainly not one we've played in the church before, so I ask you just to relax, to listen to the music, and perhaps there will be some lyrics for you to be able to read at the same time. All right, we'll see how editing goes. This song is called The Healing Has Begun, and it is by an artist named Matthew West.
You have carried the weight of your secret for way too long, thinking if there is a place called forgiveness, you don't belong. Oh, but freedom can never be found behind those walls, so just let them fall, just let them fall. The healing has begun. Whoa, the healing has begun. How long has it been since you felt anything but shame? Child, lift up your eyes, 'cause mercy remembers your name. Those tears you've been holding back, let them fall like rain. 'Cause today's the day, yeah, today's the day. From broken hearts, holding on to their guilt, thinking they fell too far. So don't be afraid to show them your beautiful scars, 'cause they're the proof. Yeah, you're the proof. Oh, the healing has begun. Oh, the healing has begun.
We are now about to enter the most important part of our service, the healing service. As we enter the healing service, let us relax and open our hearts. I will read to you the healing prayer. We ask this great unseen healing force to remove all obstructions from our minds and bodies and to restore us to perfect health. We ask this in all sincerity and honesty, and we will do our part. We ask this great unseen healing force to help both present and absent ones who are in need of help, and to restore them to perfect health. We put our trust in the love and power of God. I will now read the names of people requesting prayers for healing and prayers for progression from this side of life to the higher side of life. From the healing list, victims of catastrophic events. Men and women of the military, police, firefighters, and emergency workers who are still working during this COVID emergency. Reverend Charlotte Gordon, Reverend Betsy, Ginny, Reverend Lorraine Willey and the Rivenbergs, Donna Arsenal, Tom Smith, Reverend Tenny Komar, Jordan Newton, Reverend Eric Carlson, Venerable Man Shing, Fabiola Elisa Correa, the Baird family, Kathy Boudreau, the Gaskill family, Alcira Lloyd and Henry Lloyd, Nancy Bowmangen, Faye Newton, Lisa, Violet, and Casey, Zayden Camparelli, Marianne Sargent, Bruce Snowblind, Anthony Serino Jr., Helen Wag, Rita Cordemarsh, Nirmala, Chris Lynch, Lillian Gamble, Soren and Meredith Gamble, Jean Bowler, Jerry Casey, Rose Taft, the Avlis family, Stephen Cartan, Giselle Zangari, Kevin Lennon, Jim Westcott, Anita Wheeler, Patty Burke, Merle Newton, Muriel Arsenal, Linda, Sandra Fox, Dan Richard, Gary Porlier, Ray Beal, Nicole, Larry, Mamacita, the Cummings family. From the progression list, victims of catastrophic events, men and women of the military, police, and firefighters, as well as emergency workers and other people exposed to the contagion for our country. Leo Rondon, Jason Phillips, Asuncion Aviles, Lorraine Barton, Michael Weeks, Jonathan S. Hall, Mary Jane, Laura Lee Gamble Warhol, Samuel C. White, Reverend Eileen McGrath, Isabel Aviles Rivera, Mike House, Lily Rose, Neil Koss, Matt Hall, and Cynthia Hayes. If you have any other names that you'd like to add to this list, either healing or progression, especially during this very difficult time, please reach out to us on Facebook to add them, or reach out to me personally, and we will make sure that that happens. Obviously, we're not gathered together, so we will not have healers to come out during this time as we normally would, but what I'm going to do is do a healing at the end through a meditation. So I ask you just to hold on to that sentiment, and we will pass the healing around at the end and see if we can't bless everyone who needs it right now. Dear God, let our hands always be hands of healing, through which your life may radiate to lessen pain, to bring a renewal of peace and healing wherever needed. Dear God, let our touching hands bring some essence of your love flowing through them to bring comfort and joy. We will offer our hands and our hearts as a channel. We ask you to use us as your tools to spread this healing to others. As we pray for those in need of healing, we see them filled through and through with the healing life of God. We have faith in the remarkable ability of their body to return to the pattern of perfection in which it was created. As we pray for the healing of others, we pray also for their increased faith. We realize that it is faith that heals, and we know that God has given them a spirit of faith. We remember that Jesus said, "Your faith has made you well." Our prayer for others is that they may be receptive channels through which God can work to heal and restore them. As we pray for the healing of others, we open our mind and heart to God. We lift up our thoughts. We think of the life of God in which we live and know that this life is eternal, unending, that this life is in for those in whom we pray, a mighty healing force. Our next song is called "I Believe" by Jessica Lard.
Tells me I will never measure up. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low? Remind me once again just who I am, because I need to know. all I have, and now I'm laying it at your feet. You have every failure, God. You have every victory.
All right. So obviously, we all know there's a lot going on out there right now. We're all faced with many different levels of crisis. And crisis has always been the best tool for bringing about our own sense of faith. It's the storm that you have to get through to find the light on the other side. I talked at the beginning of the year about the astrological changes that were coming into play. The alignments, and again, I'm not an astrologist or astronomer or astrologer, so I can't tell you exactly what planets they were, but what I was told by people who do that sort of thing is that this huge astrological happening signaled the ending of one chapter, the ending of one era, the beginning of a new era. And what I was told is that it would wreak absolute havoc. Now, I am not a fearmonger, and I'm not trying to scare anyone beyond what's already been going on. I think what we're seeing now is, in fact, what I was talking about then. This is the culmination of, we need to tie up loose ends. We need to really go within. As I sit in meditation, as I talk to spirit, the messages that I get are very comforting. And so I'd like to share those with you. It's perhaps a different perspective on what we're all facing now. The first is that you're going to see fear, and you're going to see scrambling and panic if you turn the TV on, because that's what sells. The news and the media are going to push global warming, the planet's going to explode, epidemic, people are going to die. That's what sells. What spirit has told me is that with the ending of one era, they want for us to be able to really go within ourselves and to see what may be lurking, old belief systems, untied loose ends, unresolved relationships, things that were never said or never put right, that we kind of stuff down into our psyche to move on, to just get through another day. But that's not going to be good enough going forward. In this new era of light and healing, we really need to be clear of that, to be less dense, to move forward. And, you know, I always say that sometimes I'm so thick that spirit has to hit me over the head with the spiritual 2x4. This is kind of like a universal 2x4. And they said, you know, we don't want people to take this personally. And I said, spirit, how can they not take this personally? You know, we're afraid to leave our homes. Many people I've spoken to are going through extreme crisis right now, deaths, houses burning down, potentially losing jobs, on top of an epidemic, on top of being restricted to their homes, uncertainty about the future, loss of finances. You know, everyone is kind of walking on eggshells right now. And what they said to me was, well, I can see how you would think that it was personal, but it's universally personal, if that makes sense. Everyone is going through this at the same time. So while your crisis will be personal to you, I will have my own personal crises that I am going through. Everyone is having it, which in some way compounds it, because the people you normally turn to for your safety nets or for your comfort or your support are also going through their own crisis right now. But the good news is, the silver lining in all of this is that if we come to terms, if we really take this opportunity, if you will, it feels to me like Spirit has created this virus situation to force us all to seclude, to force us all to really look at what we haven't wanted to look at inside, to really sit and think about our place in the world, to do not just house cleaning, spring cleaning, things that we've been putting off, but to do some internal heart cleaning. And I've noticed that as much as there has been hoarding of foods and cleaning supplies and toilet paper and other craziness out there, I'm feeling a very post 9/11 sentiment, because we're all in this together. We're all going through our own crises as well as a global crisis together. We're all in the same boat. No one is, pardon my the turn of phrase, immune to this level of craziness that's going on around us. So whether you're sick or not, whether you're at risk or not, is really irrelevant. You're still at risk of being a carrier. You're still at risk of going to the store and finding nothing on the shelves. But in light of that, the outreach has been unbelievable. The amount of people that have stepped forward to help other people. I've been calling friends of mine, people who I might think are at risk or who I worry about, who normally I would say, well, they're fine. Under normal circumstances, they're very capable people. I have no worries about them. But in times like these, when maybe they're more at risk if they go out, if maybe the areas that they live in have less opportunities to get food or supplies, even for people that, being stuck at home, have no means of communication with anyone else. It's bad enough to be stuck at home with your family, whom you know very well. Can you imagine being home alone? Especially if you're a senior, especially if you're grieving, especially if you're sick. Please remember to reach out to your loved ones. I have been so proud and overwhelmed of our church community for having reached out to so many other people and thinking of others, even if they are at risk, to make sure that everyone else is taken care of. I have seen a level of caring with large corporations who normally you don't think really care about the little people. They're all about the bottom line. But I've seen several big companies that are putting aside their own manufacturing to start making respirators, to start making masks, to start making medical supplies and get them out. Companies that had extra medical supplies for whatever reason are donating them, turning them over. People are hand-making masks in some situations. There is a lot of good out there, and it takes a crisis of this momentum to make it so very, very visible. Wonderful things happen every day. People do kind things every day, but in the turn of the news that you would normally watch with murders, deaths, rapes, car accidents, politics, etc., one good deed gets lost in an ocean of drama. But when you're forced to sit at home, and you certainly don't want to watch the latest updates, because really, it's a matter of riding it out. It's like watching yourself lose weight. You can't just stand there on the scale all day. It doesn't tell you anything you want to hear. It doesn't change enough to make it worthwhile. There are so many good deeds that are happening now, and I'm so gratified to see that they are being highlighted, that people are recognizing the people who are on the front lines. I know that doctors and nurses signed up to put themselves in harm's way, just like police and firemen do in a different way, that they are on the front lines when these sorts of things happen. But it's still horrific, especially when they don't have the protection that they need. And for those who don't work in ICU or in areas with the infected patients, to find out that someone who came into the hospital for something completely unrelated suddenly turned out to have COVID and that they are now infected because they were not working in an infectious unit and didn't have all the protections that that unit would have. It's horrifying. It's that blank check that now they're being asked to pay. Please keep them in your hearts, keep them in your thoughts. this message is not going to be a surprise to anyone. We will get through this, and we will get through this together, but I ask you to be patient. Contagious diseases do not go away overnight. I have a friend of a good friend of mine who's a doctor, and he said that if we basically stopped the borders right now, kept anyone from any other country, and this is not a political thing, and this is not a any specific race, this is everyone. If we stop people from traveling and roaming and carrying right now, that maybe, with what we have in place, we could have a handle on this by June. And that's a long way off. Please don't think that because it doesn't seem like anything's happening outside, because you don't see anyone who's sick, because you don't feel sick, doesn't mean that it's not out there. Doesn't mean that you can't carry it. Doesn't mean that you can't give it to someone who maybe has an older person at home that is very susceptible, or small children. I don't need to lecture you. I know that you're all responsible adults. I would like to, though, remind you, please call your loved ones. Please check on your friends, even if you think that they're fine. Just because we're at home doesn't mean that we're alone. In this age of technology, you can call them, you can Skype them, you can FaceTime them. If you don't have the technology, get on an old-fashioned phone and call them. Just see how they're doing. People react differently. Everyone has their own threshold. And for those who are not on a spiritual walk, they're not used to a lot of introspection. They usually like to fill the void and fill the space with distractions, TV, music, anything to keep them going. And if they're stuck at home too long, it can be very disturbing to them. Please keep your friends and family in mind. Also, don't feel like you have to be isolated. Certainly this is, if anything else, a wonderful opportunity to pray, to meditate, to send out healing, whatever you can do, be of help to friends. But please don't feel alone in all of this. We are all in this together. We are all just a phone call away. Please don't feel like you are a burden to anyone. I don't want to bother them. I'm not going to call them. Now's the time to reach out. This is spirit kind of pushing us both to go within and to reach out at the same time. The more that you help others, the more that you help yourself. The more that you meditate and you heal yourself, the more you help others. We're all one. So please don't feel alone. You're always in my thoughts. The church, the board members are always working on new ways to keep everyone involved. We don't want anyone to feel left out. I think that's all that I have to say on the subject. There's so much going around that I don't want to overwhelm anyone. Just please know that we do care, that we are here for you. I will give you the announcements such as I have them. As of right now, everything at the church is on hold. I don't know yet whether we'll have the April psychic fair or not. The only thing that I can say is going on is that every Sunday night we do have the online intuitive development circle, 7 o'clock every Sunday night. There is a link in the Facebook page for the Wildwood. I'll make sure that I put another one up there so people know. It's a $5 requested donation paid by PayPal. Once the payment goes through, a link is sent to you for the room. It's a program that you can either have on your laptop or on your phone. If you have it on your phone, you'd probably want to download the Zoom app and sign in. It is free. No one has to pay for that. If for some reason you can't afford the $5 and you would like to attend, please just message me and we will discuss that. I don't want anyone to feel like it's not available to them. Also, after this service today, we are going to have a Zoom coffee hour. Because again, I do want all of my friends at the church to be able to get together and have discussions and see each other. So I've already put instructions up on Facebook for how to get into Zoom, but it's very easy. You just click the link and it should open in the room either on your desktop in a browser, or if you're on your phone, again, you'd probably need to download the Zoom app first. Please make sure that you sign in. And that will get you into the room. You don't need a password or anything. It is free. So if you see anything on there about buying anything, no. Just once you've signed in, you're done. You can close it. When you click the link, it will open it back up again and you'll be in the room. Okay? And if anyone has any issues with that, again, you can message me privately. I can be dealing with that on one side and the Zoom room on the other. So I don't want anyone to feel left out during this time. Okay. Also, I wanted to bring up the fact that because the church is closed, we obviously can't get donations every week. We're not in person. And I hate asking for money. I'm really not a good salesperson. Don't ever put me in charge of sales. I have put a donate button on our Facebook page for anyone who would like to donate any amount. There is no requirement, no maximum, no minimum. If you can spare anything, we certainly appreciate it, because whether we're closed or not, we still do have overhead to pay, electric bills, things like that, that still have to be paid. I botched that.
Just start over. I'll clear it up.
Also, I have put a donation button on our Facebook page. I would like to ask that anyone who is willing or able, if you could make a donation to help us to pay our bills while we are closed. We cannot take cash donations as we normally do during services, and we still do have overhead bills to pay. I know that this is a very hard time for everyone, well, with what's going on. So if you don't have it, please do not feel guilty about it. This is only if you can spare it, if you have it, if you want to donate, the abilities there to do that. So I bring that up as well. And with that, we will play our next song, which is My Sweet Lord by George Harrison. Normally, this would be the message part of our service, but because obviously we're not together today, I'm not seeing your faces, this is pre-recorded. What I'm going to do instead is something I feel that may be a little bit more necessary right now, and that is to do a healing meditation. Anyone who wishes to is invited to join in, just to listen, close your eyes, relax. If nothing else, I hope it gives you a moment of peace out of this otherwise chaotic week. But my hope is that everyone will find something a little bit healing in it. So with that, I'll see if I can't channel some of my guides to come through. They usually bring in some very profound words. I'm going to ask everyone just to be seated or lay down, whatever's more comfortable. Uncross arms and legs, and allow yourself to be heavy wherever you sit. Allow the weight of your body to really sink wherever you are seated or lying. Feel the weight of the fear and the drama and the crisis that swirls around you like angry hornets. Feel them all slowly filter downward, 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 like dust settling around you, like granules of sand sifting through the water as they find their way to the bottom, ever so gently falling away from you. Take a nice deep breath of relief. Allow the air to fill your lungs, really fill your chest cavity. We have been so compressed all week, hunched and tight, having heard the fearsome stories, the scariness that is out there, the reality of the world that we're living in, the uncertainties of the future. But now we let them fall from our back like a cape, puddle on the floor behind us. We leave those for a later time. See, sense, or imagine that the air around you is practically glowing with energy, swirling around you, scaring away the hornets, driving them away, and instead surrounding you in a giant, soft, cottony cocoon of light. Soft, gentle movement. None of the chaotic zipping and zapping around you. Warm and comforting, like being hugged with a giant warm blanket. The air itself is charged with wonderful, wonderful warm energy. And with every breath you take in lungfuls of that energy. Feel it radiating from your lungs into your bloodstream, rushing to the corners of your body, every last cell from the bottoms of your feet to the tops of your head. Slowly become entirely, entirely filled with these tiny glowing molecules of energy. And as they ignite your cells and bring to light the spark within you, all of the negativeness, all of the fear, all of the worry, all of the anxiety is driven away like darkness when a light's turned on. These fears cannot live in the light of the divine. These anxieties cannot exist within the light of the divine. And your body is full to overflowing. Your body is practically glowing with the light of the divine that fills you even now. Feel your muscles warm and relax. Slowly lengthen and release. Such a heavy week we've had. It feels so good to just let it go. Release and relax. See, sense, or imagine that directly over your head is an amazing, brilliant spotlight, like a shining star beaming down directly at you, your divine connection, source energy, divine creator. who knows you for who you truly are at your soul, who has always known you long before you were who you are now. They know the real you, not the face you see in the mirror, not the person who deals with your life. They know your soul, and it is a wonderful homecoming. This light knows you. This light birthed you. Divine Mother Energy wraps their arms around you and holds you close like a long-lost child. So proud of you. So adoring of you. You are the most precious child ever. Mother Energy sits with us, holds us, comforts us, and we know that no harm can come to us. We are held within the arms and the embrace of the divine. And in this warm, sacred space that is created for you and you alone, the healing of the universe steps in. Archangel Raphael, Master Healer, who brings in all of the healing of the universe, all of the love of the universe. Divine Child, know that we are with you always. We hold your glowing heart in our hands, all of us here. We feel your pain. We feel your anxiety. And as you suffer, we too suffer. How can we not? You are our most precious, precious child. Know that we love you always. This situation will not last forever. That does not mean that it is not difficult while going through it. But understand that the stormiest seas, scary as they may be, will end in smoother seas in the end, and a clear voyage to a new place. We are asking that you shine the light of our divine love into your own heart. Find those moments, find those beliefs, find those unreconciled emotions, and allow them to surface without pushing them away, without resisting. But instead, find compassion in your heart, maybe for those who have wronged you, maybe for those that you have wronged, for you must have compassion for yourself as well. This exercise, if we can call it that, this situation at large, this is an opportunity for all of mankind to find the love for themselves, and that is for you as well. For if you truly know, understand, forgive, and love yourself, truly love yourself, then how could you not have compassion and love for one another? How could there be wars? How could there be hunger? How could there be homelessness? We first must love each other through ourselves. So many people seek God from without, outside of themselves, through a religious building, through an organization, through a book, through learnings, through teachings, through gurus, through masters. But in the end, God is really within you, not without you. You need only look into your own heart to find the love of God there. And so when you say your prayers at night, speak inward, not outward. Do not turn your head to the sky for some almighty being above you who sits in judgment. Turn your thoughts inward to your own heart. Thank you, Divine Creator, for this life that you have given me. That is where you will find the Divine Creator. He does not exist on a cloud above you. He is in everything around you. and in you. So how can you not survive this? How can you not get through this? God literally lives within you, in your body. We will all get through this. You will get through this. I understand that it feels scary if you look at it through your ego. But your soul knows. The danger is not real per se, it is an illusion. This is an opportunity for everyone to go within and to find the love for themselves. This is celestial permission to stay at home and do the most important work that you can do, the healing of your own hearts. And all of the angels will be there to assist you. Know this. We are all here holding your heart in our hands. We call for all of the light and love that exists within the divine creation, as immense as it is, from all parts of the universe, to come and assist now in your healing. If you know people who also need healing, carry them in your heart, and as you are healed, so they will be healed, for what we do for one, we do for all. Know that everyone's needs will be met. We work through other people as much as we work through miracles. Do not be afraid to call a friend and ask for help, because we have made people available to carry this mission for you, or made you available to carry this mission for others. Please do not ever be afraid to ask for help when you need it. Some people give us the opportunity to work through them, and it is a great honor for them to do so. Please allow them that honor. Give them that opportunity. Likewise, certainly, we welcome service from all people. If you would like to be of service, we will always be welcomed to step into your heart and ask you. Please know that we love you. Please know that we are with you. Please know that we walk every step of the way with you, and you are not as alone and isolated as you may think you are. For we are always watching, and we are always here. We regret that so many who are already walking the path and already healing and working are also being isolated at this time. But much is required to shift the energy as we move forward into a new coming era of peace and healing. We start with you now. Know that we do this all out of love. There is no punishment in this. We do not want for anyone to suffer. Please accept our love and healing, our light and guidance, and know that you may call upon us at any time, for we are always here through you. And we love you. Divine Mother Energy holds you close, pulls you in, comforts and warms you. You can feel the heartbeat of God, the heartbeat of Mother Earth. Feel the pulsating warmth through your body as it beats your heart for you, as it breathes your lungs for you, as it sends its energy, healing energy, pulsing through you. Allow it to boost your immune system. Allow it to bring you calm. Allow it to bring you peace and understanding. Know that this love is always here for you. Always here. And that at any moment, you can decide to relax, close your eyes, and take a deep breath, and be back in the Divine Mother's arms again. And she will hold and comfort you any time that you need. She is here for all of us. And you are a beloved, precious child of the Divine. Know that above all things. Allow this healing to course through your veins, move through your skin, gently move around you. Soft breezes, warm breaths, cottony warmth that just surrounds you and wraps you gently, holds you in a way that is comforting and firm but does not crush you. Always you are safe here. Always you are well here. Always you are loved here. This energy remains with you long after you've seen the service, long after you've returned to your life. This healing stays with you, rooted in your blood, rooted in the oxygen and the cells in your body. They have been sparked into awareness. They connect rapidly with the divine anytime you need. Your body is your own antenna. Remember that your divine soul lives within you. You can make connection anytime. You can also spread this healing to others. You can radiate this energy outwards. You can share it. This love is meant for all. And with love and compassion, we will all come to learn to love ourselves and love each other. Very slowly, calmly, feeling that warmth as it surrounds us, fills us to overflowing with joy, peace, comfort. We allow that sense of comfort and peace to remain, even as we very slowly bring our awareness back to our bodies, back to our limbs, feeling the furniture underneath us, the temperature of the room on our skin, the feeling of your clothing against your very body. Slowly, slowly let your consciousness refill your body, still keeping that wonderful sense of calm, connection, and healing, but filling it with your consciousness at the same time. And as you come back to yourself, when you are fully aware and able, feel free to open your eyes and rejoin. And I hope that that journey was healing for everyone. For our last song today, I would like to play God Be With You Till We Meet Again by Ella Fitzgerald.
God be with you till we meet again. By his counsels guide, uphold you. With his sheep securely fold you. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet, till we meet, till we meet at Jesus' feet. till we meet,
till we meet,
till we meet. God be with you till we meet again.
Please join us next in a Zoom coffee hour. Grab your favorite beverage, coffee, tea, water, whatever, and join us there for some socialization and some much-needed reconnection. Thank you again for joining us today, and we hope we'll see you again in the future. Please watch our Facebook page for our announcements as to when we'll be reopening and how we will continue to get services to you. Thank you so much, and know that we're here for you. For the benediction, Divine Creator, thank you again for all the love that you share with us, for keeping us healthy, keeping us strong, and keeping us there for each other. Let there always be friends in the world who care for one another, but more so, let there always be strangers in the world who will show the same caring. Amen. Join us on Zoom. Thank you.